there. My name is Sally Almasref. I'm a solutions engineer here at QBuild Software, and I handle our NetSuite and Oracle practice. Before we start delving into the demo, we're very excited to introduce you to QBuild. We're the industry leaders in integrating engineering software to ERP, providing customer-centric service to over 2,000 discrete manufacturers. We're partnered with over 50 engineering and ERP systems, and we are an international company with offices around the globe, which really allows us to connect to customers from various different time zones and communicate in their language of choice. QSuite, which is our comprehensive solution suite, includes CADLink, ECX Manager, NestLink, and more, and allows us to empower our customers with streamlined processes and ensuring significant cost savings to allow for efficiency and accuracy every step of the way. Now, today we're going to demo CADLink to connect Inventor and NetSuite ERP. Before we start, let's take a look at the differences between the pain points associated with manual data entry versus using integration through CADLink. So as you can see here on this process chart, manual data input is very time-consuming and causes errors and inconsistencies between your CAD data and NetSuite, which eventually causes downstream confusion, maybe scrap parts, and increased costs. Now, on the other hand, with CADLink, you can synchronize a bill of material with just a click of a button to ensure that you can get that BOM manufactured accurately from engineering all the way through to production from the very first try. So a lot more of a streamlined process and allows you to spend more time on actual engineering and design work rather than focusing on manual clerical work. So with that being said, let's go ahead and start the demo. So CADLink is a tool that is designed for the engineers. And as such, it actually is an add-in directly in your CAD software. So what I've got opened up here is my Inventor model. I'm using Autodesk Inventor. And let's say that I've just finished making some changes to this design here. I've added some sub-assemblies, I've removed some components, modified some components. Whatever the case is, I now have this new revision of my bill of materials, and I need that reflected over into NetSuite. So what I'm going to do is navigate to my add-in. You'll notice this QBuild CADLink add-in. I'm simply going to click on this CADLink button. And at this point in time, CADLink is going to initiate a comparison of data between all of the information I have in this assembly model in Inventor compared to what I have in my NetSuite database in real time. So it is not a background application or a simple data dump that just, you know, pushes data into NetSuite without giving you the visibility or the validation first. It's actually running through a live comparison, showing you the result of that comparison through the color-coded grid here, and giving the user a chance to make informed decisions about all of this, all these changes in your BOM before you give it the green light and the thumbs up and push this information all through to NetSuite. So if you take a look at the left-hand side here, you'll notice this very first column, this number column, all of these indentations are my parent-child relationship. So I've got my top level, first subassembly under there, all of the components underneath that, and really the structure is going to be maintained from that assembly, that 3D model in Inventor, all the way through to NetSuite so that it is not being manipulated along the way. And that design that we're spending a lot of time on creating is going to be reflected accurately in NetSuite. Next, let's talk about these colors. So of course, from a visual standpoint, each color has a significance. We start off with this white item here. This is an item that already exists in NetSuite. It matches with the items that I've got in Inventor. And so all of these white rows that are highlighted in completely white are already in sync. So NetSuite and Inventor are both synchronized with the same exact information. Now, if I take a look at one of these yellow highlights, so whether it's my description or my quantity or my BOM revision that's highlighted in yellow, these are field level discrepancies. So although my data, my item itself, it already exists in NetSuite, there's already a record of it there, there are some differences to the field level. And if I right click on this description, you can see that my descriptions here in Inventor versus what's in NetSuite are completely different. So perhaps, you know, somebody put in the wrong information on the ERP side, perhaps the engineers didn't have the correct information in Inventor. Regardless of what the case is and why there's a difference from the two data sets, we have a chance here to rectify that difference. And because CADLink is bidirectional, we're able to decide which of these two descriptions do I want to use, both in NetSuite and also in Inventor, so that I don't have to go back to my design and make the changes to my I property there. So in this case, let's say I'd actually like to use this ERP description instead. I can go ahead and select that. And then this description that I have shown on my interface will be updated back to Inventor. Now, alternatively, if I don't like what's coming in from NetSuite and what I have in Inventor, and I want to completely override this description, I have the option of doing just that. So in my case here, I'm going to type in demo description. And once I hit save, this description here that I've typed in is going to be updated both in NetSuite and back to Inventor, even though it's not being driven by either of those systems. So a little bit of flexibility here to be able to modify descriptions on the fly directly in the interface without having to go into Inventor to make that change there and then, you know, go into NetSuite to make that same change twice. Now, if we switch gears a little bit to these green rows, so these are brand new components that have been designed for the very first time. Your Inventor designers have created these new parts, and they now need these parts to exist in NetSuite. So what CADLink's going to do specifically for the green rows is to create a record of each of these items. So we're going to create this assembly item, this inventory item, and we're also going to add them to the bill of materials components. So a couple steps that you would otherwise have to go into NetSuite to do manually, all of those are going to be done once you hit the save button, and it's going to be done all in an instance. Now lastly, these gray rows here are items that need to be removed from my NetSuite BOM because they no longer exist in my CAD design. So at one point in time, these two items existed in Inventor, which is why they're currently in NetSuite. But moving forward, I've removed them. Maybe they've become obsolete. Maybe I've replaced them with different components. Regardless of the fact, these two items need to be removed from my NetSuite bill of materials to match that updated design. And so CADLink is going to do exactly that. It's going to remove these two components from my bill of materials. It's not going to touch the item record because we understand that it may still be used for other assemblies. It may have transactions built against it. So regardless of the fact, these two components will be maintained as item records. We're just simply going to update the next BOM revision in NetSuite. And one more color that is not currently on the screen is a feature unique to CADLink, and it is called a manual part. Now, what this allows you to do is to add components to the bill of materials that are not CAD driven. So you can think of consumables like bolts, nuts, glue, paint, user manuals, adhesives, anything of the like that you don't necessarily need to model in Inventor. So in my case, I'm going to look for a bolt here, but you do want to add them to your NetSuite bill of materials. So what CADLink is going to do here is it's going to give me a list of all the items that currently exist in NetSuite that match this criteria that I've typed in. So I'm looking for an item that contains something along the lines of the word bolt to my display name. And if I scroll through, I have the chance here to choose which item I'd like to add to my NetSuite bill of materials only. So let's say I'd like to use that first one there. Going to hit accept. And now you'll notice a blue row at the very end of my BOM here. So this blue row is telling me that I've added this component manually. It's not something that's modeled or driven by Inventor, although I do need it in my bill of materials for manufacturing purposes. And at this point in time, because I am adding this component and this piece of hardware manually, I do have to specify to CADLink how many of these components I would like to add to my BOM. So in my case here, I'm going to add a dozen. And moving forward, the next time around that I launch CADLink on either the subassembly or the top level here, it is going to maintain my blue manual part because it's going to remember that I added it the last time around. So it is only a step that needs to be done once, and CADLink will recognize it the next time around. All right, scrolling to the right here. So we've got your additional columns. So things like your class, your department, item source. These are all NetSuite specific fields that need to be handled for new items in particular. So when I'm creating a new item, I need to know, you know, what's the units type I want to use, what's the class, what's the department. And in order to do so, CADLink actually will set up default values for each of these brand new components. So you'll notice for my units type, I've got the default of each for these green rows. For class, I've defaulted to internal. And beyond these defaults, you can, as a user, choose a different value for these new items. So these dropdowns are pulled from your NetSuite instance, gives you a chance to specify some of these ERP-specific values right on the fly here as you're creating the new item through CADLink without having to step into the ERP system at all. So we're ensuring that any rules or mandatory fields that need to be followed in NetSuite are also reflected here in the CADLink interface. So at this point in time, once I hit save, CADLink is going to create these green rows for me, update any discrepancies with these yellow highlights, in addition to remove these gray rows that are no longer part of my design, and add any manual components that I inserted into my bill of materials here. So with that being said, at the click of a button, all of these changes will take place without you having to manually put all these details in line item, row by row. And it really will allow you to streamline the process of getting that bill of material information and your item details in NetSuite accurately the very first time around. If you're ready to take your workflow to the next level, please schedule a demo with us on our website. You can simply click the link in the description below and we can get started to discuss how we can improve your efficiency today. So thank you so much for watching. That's all for today. I hope you found this insightful. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more content similar to today's video. And don't forget to follow us on LinkedIn for some more daily updates. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.